Hi everyone. So I am Sindhijan. I am from Faculty of Information Technology. So this is our group project that we done in fourth year. So hybrid movie recommendation system. And so our supervisors are Dr. C.R. J. Amalraj, Mrs. Veera Sinkar. So this is our team members, and these are outlines that we are going to explain in this session. So if you take introduction, so you know recommender system is a kind of filtering system. So where we filter the user data based on the user past and current experiences. So in here movie recommendation, what we are going to do, we take a history about the user's past data and current data and predictive future of the user behavior. So that's the things behind the recommender system. So in movie recommender system, you can see there are three broad groups. So that is content, collaborative, and hybrid recommender system. So if you take others way, you can see these are the researchers. They done the research in the movie recommender system. So the first one is Sri Reddy. He's done content based approach technique is gender correlation, and the issue that we found the limited content analysis. So likewise, you can see the Rani Habibs Singh and Ramil G. Lomak et Kyongso Romantar Mishra Hamid. Those are done research over the movie recommendation system under the separate categories like collaborative memory, collaborative model. So the techniques that they use, cause and similarity, user similarity, content. Likewise, they have done, and we found the issues on over the messages. So this works. So the hybrid approach. So this also kind of existing research that already in the already in there. So the Raghul Kattar has done that. So the technique he used came in Google search issues. Is he didn't properly divide the part, and that didn't work well. So that's the thing issue that we found. And so our work is, so this is our work. So our approach is content, collaborative memory, collaborative model. So what is our technology is choosing the best algorithm by analyzing and explaining the multiple different classifiers with the different metrics. So the improvement is improve the performance of the prediction, reduce sparsity, increase reliability, remove the cold start. The cold start is a kind of problem that we don't have a recommendation movie for the new users. So this is our aim and objective, reduce the issues in existing recommendation system by enhancing the performance. So this is our object, identify the approach by analyzing, exploring existing classifiers and recommend similar movies based on the attribute of the movies. And recommend similar movies for the target user based on the other user's similar ratings. Likewise, this is our objective. So our approach is content, collaborative model. For the content, we are using TF-IDF with cosine, collaborative, truncated SVD with Pearson, collaborative model. SVD implement them in a hybrid approach. We can use two of the approach to implement the hybrid approach. So this is our data set that we use TMTB. So it has 4,500 movies data set from 270 users. So hybrid way, so you can see this is an abstract level of diagram of our system. In here, user has a recommend system, then that request goes to the into the system, and this is into the system. We are having a content based with collaborative memory or content based with collaborative model. So based on that, it will provide a recommend system to the users. So content based system filter. This is the content based filter in here. So initially we put the users watched movie data. So the content based system is the what it does. It takes the data and filter the best of movies based on the users past history and the current history and suggest those movies to the current user. Based on the similar movies, it will suggest the recommendation system. So this is our implementation. Here is convert the movie data set into the Python object, and that Python object will find the similarity between the movies, then based on the according to the TF-IDF approach. So according to that, we will provide the recommendation. So this is kind of a filter evaluation. These are the techniques that we use: positive value, negative value, true positive, false negative, true negative. And the content-based filter, these are the metrics that we use to measure the filter, measure the accuracy of the content-based filter. So precision, recall, F1 score. Precision is after predicted value, how many values are true value. Likewise, recall is how many values are true in prediction out of real value. The F1 score, the standard weighted averages of precision and recall. So in Hindenburg filter, so we calculated the precision recall efforts per power research based on the movies taken from Google with the predicted recommended movies of targeted users. So that's the input of the Hindenburg system. So user was, for example, user was movie Iron Man, and two similar movies, Iron Man 2, Iron Man 3, and predicted movies, Iron Man 2, Spider-Man. So here is one is error. So that's our accuracy. So you can see that this is the data that we measured from our research from the content-based filter. So as per that, precision recall reference scores are 0.83, 0.83, 0.84. So it means for the, if we take precision 0.3 means, so after one movies, we found a 0.83 movies. So I would like to call Mr. Krishanthi to continue the session from here. Krishanthi, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Sindhian. Now I am going to explain memory-based filter. Memory filter nominates the movies to the target user by finding the similar movies based on user ratings. And to find the similar movies for the target user, it uses the past user rating over the movies. Here we take the input user-watched movies. Then some process occurred, such as convert the user's rating data into the data frame from the main data set. Then using ranked SPD approaches with the Pearson correlations to find similarity between users for the target user based on other users' rating to the pair of movies. Then gather the top similar movies based on the similarity. After all step finished, I recommend the high similarity movies to the target users. Mean absolute error and root mean square error both are used to evaluate the memory-based filter. Mean absolute error is a difference between the actual value and the predicted value. Root mean square error means the standard deviation of the prediction error. Here we use 100,000 ratings to find the mean absolute error and root mean absolute error. This slide shows the memory-based filter evaluations. We can see the results in this slide. Now I invite Tamlini to continue the presentation.
Thank you, Krishanthi. I'm going to explain about the model-based filter. This filter compresses huge database into a model which can predict the movie ratings for a target user. If the predicted rating is high, then the movie will be recommended to the users. And when we talk about the implementation, here is the simple implementation of the model-based filter. Target user and movie are going to be the inputs. And after that, what we are going to do is we convert the data into data frame. After that, using the data frame, we will create the train data set. Using the train data set, we will use the algorithm like a single value decomposition. Based on the train data set, it will create the prediction model. This prediction model will predict the movie rating on behalf of the user. As Krishanthi said, her mean absolute error and root mean square error are going to evaluate this movie recommendation movie model based filter as well. This is the result set for our this model based filter. Here we use the 5 folds, and you can see the results here. And in future, we can further reduce the cost of the execution or running time of each filter system of the recommendations. And as well, we are going to plan to improve the accuracy. Thank you.